Before Southwest Africa became Namibia, this was bushmanland. Being San or Bushman has always meant discrimination. The new day is bringing changes for Namibia's San children. The old ways are dying. Free primary education was one of the fruits of independence, but not for everybody. Many San children are not in school. Now they are raising their voices. In the modern world, San culture lives on as a tourist attraction. The menstruation dance is still an important part of San tradition, which valued storytelling above formal learning. In the audience is Twisa Twi, a student at the Polytechnic of Namibia. There are only three San students in higher education in Namibia. Twisa comes from a small village called Grasuk, where his parents still gather bush food, like mangeti nuts. The nearest road is half a day's walk from Grasuk. The children wait for a lift to school, but they are not always lucky. For these children, the nearest school is 40 kilometers away, and the next one 70. There are no San people to care for them at the school hostel, and the parents have no way of knowing if their children will be safe. Although apartheid has gone, the San continue to labor for other groups. Near to the Botswanan border, they herd cattle for Tswana and Herero farmers. The wages are pitiful. Aaron never went to school. He asks, how can you go to school when you are a slave? But times are changing. His children go to the nearest primary school, 20 kilometers away. Not many San attend, and still fewer make it to the higher grades. Isaac is an exception and should complete his education.
Well, he was all the time, he was teacher's blue-eyed boy. They had him as a class captain and give him things to do and ask him things to do, and he's getting the keys of the class, and his attitude is right. And he's into his work. He's positive.
Yes, do you understand anything?
Yes.
Fine, go on.
Ask Isaac about school, and he will tell you that money is all that counts. Primary education is free, but the schools demand extra funds to pay for repairs and many things the government can't afford.
My policy with them is as if it is possible for them and with time come and they can contribute to these funds, we'll be glad. But otherwise, it's not as if we can expel the children if they don't pay their school funds.
The community eyes the school suspiciously. The headmaster is a farmer, and a rumor is going around that he made San children work for him to pay the school fund.
No, that's a lie. Genuinely, that's a lie. Well, I said to the children, they can come to my house here and they can wash my car, for instance, I can pay them money and they can contribute to the school fund, something like that maybe, but it never happened.
Mr. Nell is furious and wants to hear for himself. Isaac's community is poor. The adults never went to school. They are astonished to see the headmaster here.
Luister mense, ek is bly jy sit hierso. Ek het 'n probleem. Jy het 'n storie vir hulle vertel wat nie vir my pas nie en jy het van my gepraat. Jy het gesê die skoolhoof vat die kinders en hy laat werk dit op hulle plaas om gras te trek en ek weet nie wat alles te doen vir die varke en so nie en so betaal hulle hulle skoolfonds.
Okay. School of Nell het gekom en gesê, so die kinder van die boesman sê, gaan gratis school in die 13 in. En die daddy hero, wat is sy naam?
Kapama
het gesê, so daar bestaan nie a gratis school van die boesman sê nie. Hulle kan nou nie die school betaal en ons sê, onze kinders moet gratis school gaan nie.
Ja, okay, wacht nou, goed, jy praat nou ook lang story. Soos ek die story gehoor het, ek vat die kinders na my plaas toe. Is dit reg of verkeerd?
Dis nie so gesê nie.
Nee, maar goed, okay, maar toot, hulle het dit vir my genoem.
Ons het vir die skole, of ons is die kakakotake as, of hoe hou die kota? Mister, ek hou my hier vraag.
Kan julle nie mooi Afrikaans praat hier nou, of is dit tolk?
Nee, maar hulle soek nie. Hulle soek nie.
The parents feel powerless, and the school seems unable to understand the community.
Ja, maar luister, kyk, hom nie jare vat om te praat. Die praat die dinge wat nodig is.
Nee, dit is
waar hulle. Vra hy, dan vra hulle, maar ek moet ook hoor.
Skoonheid is a government resettlement farm for the San. Here, former hunter-gatherers and expert cattle herders have been settled to plant crops. The irrigation system doesn't work, and the people have no income. The chief would like the people to pay school funds, but wonders how.
School funds in the good battery can pay. The drink out for a one who walk out some America battery can school funds. Then I got on my wadama. I'll let some of our lace. Kaka gusega. Gusto drama kwan ay musikwan ng tuwing eskada maalte ito ang oding kukwa ke ahing kwa kwan amalita utong drama kwan amali ako sisi yile skuni dibi kwa sa ugashi kumaj mga asam kanja skuni tiya tsehe kum ekka kwa kwan amali.
Dina Lucas is 10. She comes from Skoonhaid. Like many San girls, she dropped out of school early and wants to start again. She is hoping for a place in one of the few schools friendly to the San. Gaina takes children from Skoonhaid and from commercial farms. The children don't know what to expect because their parents never went to school. Learning to play and integrate can be difficult.
They need a special place where people understand their needs. Many of these children, especially in the beginning, they didn't have any idea of what school was. They didn't know books, they didn't know pencils and all these things. Whereas you have the town children who grow up with these things. And this, we felt this is a need. You have to prepare them for school, prepare them for a different environment, totally different to what they are used to.
Audax is a large commercial farm. Kuki Metzger employs many San workers. He makes sure that the children go to Gaina. They are looking forward to school, but know they must watch out for themselves. The children will stay in the school hostel for a whole term. Cookie thinks the 400-kilometer round trip to Gaina is worth it.
If they drop out of school after 5 or 6 or 8 or 10 years, then they at least they learn to think and get used to use their brain. And I think it's a good investment later on than my son or my kids can use more better farm workers. But if they don't perform, I take them out. So the kids who don't perform, I don't waste my money on them. Then they can go back to the farm.
Like many farmers, Cookie will tell you that investing in San girls is a waste of money. They just get pregnant. But he takes them to school all the same and pays Gaina's fees. His biggest hope is that one of them will become a teacher. Dina was not admitted. She is under 16. She has not completed primary school. The constitution guarantees her an education, but doesn't say where.
We have problems with these older children. They don't fit in with the class group. If you have an 11-year-old in grade 1 who has to play around doing grade 1 things, it just doesn't work.
Thank you.
tend to drop out later as well, because then they are at the getting married stage in the San community. The children get married very young. They take a husband when they are 14, 15 years old. So they are halfway through with their education and then they move off to get married.
The chief feels he has no influence at the school.
Hello, Yevro.
The headmistress maintains that Gaina's doors are always open to parents, and especially to their representatives, like Chief Langman. She knows that home life cannot be separated from school performance.
Some children, if they have been home for a weekend, you can judge what happened at home by the child's behavior the next few days in class. You will have problems with that child if he didn't have a good weekend at home. Maybe the father hit the mother, or maybe there was a fight between drunk parents. You've got to try and persuade them that what they see at home isn't right. It isn't the best.
Frederick Langman wants the best for the children. To ease the transition to school, he helped translate into Chumkwa from Afrikaans.
Daar's 'n Frits, wat se werk doen papa?
In theory, children should start to learn in their own language. In practice, San children must adapt quickly to Afrikaans or English. Only two qualified teachers in Namibia speak Chumkwa.
You can go anywhere in the world and people will all be taught in their own languages. Afrikaans people are taught in Afrikaans, Herero children are taught in Herero, German children are taught in German. So why shouldn't the San people be taught in their own language?
Bushman land is changing. In the Nainai Conservancy, the San control the land they live on. The people have taken a step further. They have built village schools where children can learn in their own language, Chumkwa, for the first 3 years. Teaching materials which follow the Chumkwa oral tradition have been developed, using stories told for generations by the fireside. The teachers are San. None of them finished school, and they are learning on the job. Motivation is the main qualification. Teacher training is provided in the villages. If the parents help to run the schools, the dropout rate for pupils should be reduced. Children are often absent or late. The daily trek to school can be more than 5 kilometers, and there are other reasons to be late for class. The solution seemed simple. The community would build donkey carts to take the children to school. But all of them are broken, and nobody seems willing to repair them. After the first 3 years, the children should be ready to go to the state boarding school and integrate with other Namibians. Tsumkwe School, 40 kilometers away. So many San children drop out, they are in the minority.
Some of them, they come for the first time in Tsumkwe. The life which is somewhat a bit different from a child who grew up right in a sunny village where there's not too much exposure of different people. Maybe he or she is used to his or her own parents. Sometimes they feel somehow inferior among the other kids. But those kids, they are somehow shy.
It's a new school. They don't know whom to play with. And also there's a difficulties because if they come here, the other kids who are here are beating them, and then that's why they run away. And then sometimes they also said that it's not only that, if they came from village schools to this school, other kids are laughing at them because they don't have school uniforms and they are not wearing nice clothes, and that's one of the reasons why they run away.
Again, the Nainai village schools had a novel idea. They loaned two trainee sand teachers to Tsumkwe school. Paula Manuel is one of them.
I feel she's quite a good role model in this school. Because when I look at the sunny girls, not even one has gone up to grade 10. They go as far as grade 8, they are pregnant, they go out for marriage. But when they've got a person like Paula, they can easily go to her and talk to her.
Lucia's family are not sure if school is best. At home in Grasshook, girls still follow the traditions. The menstruation ceremony is an important rite of passage for San girls, with marriage next. According to some, tradition hampers education. It should be put in the archives. The principal remembers one girl.
See, when I sit outside behind the hostels there, for 3 days we don't sing. And later on, when she was asked, she was saying that, no, she was supposed to dig a hole and sit there so that all the whole thing is done into that hole and cover it up. Or whether, I don't know whether she will be shifting from one hole to another, or she will sit on one hole until she finished. But she was staying away from others until that process was over, which means it's their traditional active life which they have. We don't ignore their culture and all the like, but we try by all means sometimes to teach them also what happens in the modern world. Because at the end of the day, they will be learning. We are encouraging them to learn, to go further with their studies. Suppose the child goes to London and he is still using the traditional method. And when you are in London, maybe you are right in the city center, everything is paved up with the slabs of cement. She won't be able to dig the hole. So it's better to teach them both the methods of how to nest themselves, which I think is very good.
San parents want more understanding for their children, and San staff at the hostel to protect them, especially from sexual harassment. Paula Manuel remembers her days at school.
En altijd deed voor mij geroep. Hij kon geven mijn broer die zei mijn kind gaan roep je ma. Hij heeft me gestuurd naar een schoolkind. Ze is ook een boosman met zijn kind. En dan moet ik die brood eten en die met zijn kind gaan roep. En als ik niet verder gaan roep, niet, ik krijg niet ander ochtend brood niet.
Times are changing. The headmistress is happy to have a San representative on the school board. He feels that things will only improve if the school listens to the ideas from the community.
I'm not saying only Paula, but I think if there was more Zhunghua teachers, it will make it, more comfortable for the kids to go to the school.
Paula has traveled far down the long road to education. While she burns the night oil to become a fully qualified teacher, she dreams about the future.
As a miskin oka school mark for Bushmans, and the Bushmans is the meeste kinders op die school. And the other nasi is men. Then As they take the lesi buy bank for the van the lesi na les buy, and as they eat they under nasi eat mak, then sell it ook iets terug prat of as they level for the slang, then sell it ook terug slang.